Hey everyone, I thought it might be fun for all of you to see how this year's very special production of Surealia came into reality. So I've decided to take it upon myself to create a little mini-series for you all about the making of the production. So we're going to talk about story, the characters, filming, all that stuff. So I really hope you enjoy. So my family's production of Surealia has been and always will be a massive part of my life and ultimately who I am as a person. It's concepts, it's music, it's characters, it's writing, all of that stuff have just bled into every single facet of my creative psyche. This ballet has quite literally been a part of my life since the very, very beginning. We have some very early VHS recordings of the shows down in California before there was a studio Roxander. And in one of the blackouts, you can hear me giggle in the audience as an infant. So this is another reason why it was so hard on me missing last year's performance, the 2022 performance, because I was working here in New York. But even though I couldn't be there in body, I was perhaps in spirit, more connected to my family's production than ever before. The idea was developed in 1996, 6 years before I was born, to give you some perspective. And it all began when my father and my grandmother, Jody White, sat down in a little restaurant in San Jose. Their ballet school, Dance Theater 7, for those of you who don't know, was new then, and very small, and they desired to create a production more unique than simply another retread of the Nutcracker as their annual full-length ballet. So they decided to come up with a concept that would create dances and ballet that would change every single year as the school changed. In other words, it felt to them that it would evolve along with the students in it. This open-ended style allowed them to use dancers much, much more than your average classical ballet. They use artists like singers within the production, talents that were generally not used in ballets whatsoever. And they also completely discarded the notion of a single composer. So they wanted all kinds of completely eclectic music. The same went with choreography. They wanted ballet, they wanted modern, they wanted contemporary, neoclassical, and even more. Just all mushed together in a hodgepodge, as my father would say. Once they established their crazy idea, all that was left for this hodgepodge was a title. Thank you. And there you have it. Surealia was born. 27 years and approximately 22 different performances. So you might be asking yourself at this point, how did this year's version come along? Like always, there were talks about the future of Surealia once we finished Surealia the Lost Archives. Talks about how we could potentially move forward with the story and characters. I began to contrive quite a few extremely vague ideas following our first showing of the Lost Archives to the school. It was kind of like a giant watch party for those of you who couldn't make it. We projected the film on the psych at our home theater, Creative Performing Arts Center, for the whole school to see, along with their families and friends. It was really a magical moment, I think, for my family to see all of this hard work we put in during COVID, which was a very hard time for the school, and watch it come to fruition. And its apparent appreciation from all of you that were there really took a fire that was already in me and just poured lighter fluid on it. I mean, that might be a bad analogy, but that's honestly the best one I got. I was in what my parents like to call full-blown Surealia mode. It was constant. It was, what if we do this? What if we do that? Oh, well, maybe we should ditch that character and bring in this character. What if we did this? And what if? So I was just constantly talking because I felt so inspired. My poor parents, I was practically keeping them hostage to my creative and chaotic hurricane in between my two ears. Though through all of that creative chaos, three ideas always remained constant. They were three diamond absolutes in my mind, and thankfully, my parents were fond of them as well. Number one, I wanted to do a prequel. If there's one thing that ever kind of concerned me about Surealia, it was that as the story and the characters kept on beautifully progressing and evolving, it became harder and harder for new audience members to soak in and understand completely. So, knowing my father loves to start anew and reboot things, so to speak, as I'm sure all of you know, I knew going to him with the idea of doing a prequel wouldn't be a terribly hard sell. And luckily, I was right. The purpose of going backward, to me, was to kind of start from scratch and give extra meaning to the seemingly, random pieces of choreography and characters within Surealia, so that audience members that are completely new to the production could fully understand and appreciate the show. Although I was certain that with an idea like this one would bring a considerable amount of aha moments for the more familiar audience members. So the Studio Roxander students and the families and people that have been following the show for years. Some of the references and Easter eggs within this show, I'm really not sure anyone will notice but myself, but we'll see, you never know. At least this was the basic idea. The new could enjoy wholeheartedly as well as the old. So, once we decided on doing a prequel, the question was, what does that look like? Are we going back in time within the world of Surealia, or is this happening in the real world, or a bit of both? One of the best things about Surealia is also one of the biggest pains in the butt, and that's the fact that it's so open-ended. You can really do anything. So it was difficult, but also extremely enjoyable to explore all of the possibilities. I wanted to really solidify that we were in the past, So what better way of doing that than setting the show in the past and making everything that plays in the real world a period piece? Then it was just all about pick an era. And of course, it's probably no surprise to anyone who knows me, I picked my favorite era, the 60s. Please keep your eyes peeled for part two, where I'm going to be talking about what I know all of you Studio Roxanders want me to be talking about, the character Orion, and how one idea from my father, one teeny snippet from the Lost Archives, grew into the whole focus of this year's production. Till then, I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. Okay.
Yeah, I probably need to have some like until like here. So,